Welcome once again to Inside Athletics, brought to you by the IAAF. I'm your host, Atto Bolden. Every now and then in this role, I get to interview somebody who I looked up to when I was thinking about getting into the sport. And tonight we have one of those examples, Heike Dreschler of Germany, who has 5 Olympic medals, including 2 in the long jump. Heike, welcome to the program. I want to know, how have you been keeping and what have you done post-career with your passion for athletics?
Oh, it's, with 27 years in the sports and always a passion, and I grew up with this passion and still in passion for this nice sport. And I love long jump and sprinting still.
Now, I look back at your record and it was amazing. World record long jump, tying the world record in the 200. You had such range, 1, 2, long jump. How come we see that so seldom these days?
I think it's long jump is a technical event, and you need more technical, especially when you're growing up, when you're a child, you have to learn this technical. When you don't have this technical, it's very, it's not so good, I think, when you're growing up, and then you miss these technical things. Just the sprint is not enough for long jump.
Exactly.
Carl Lewis was was a big athlete, and he can make boats, but he learned this technique when he was young. So he have a brilliant technique. He was so my experience for this technique in long jump.
Really?
Yes, really.
Now, one of the reasons why I wanted to get into the sport is because I turned on the TV and I watched you and Jackie Joyner-Kersee go head to head. And even then I knew these are two of the best that we will ever see. Tell me about some of your memories about competing against Jackie Joyner-Kersee.
Yeah, it was nice competition always.
Yes,
we was 180% in the competition. When she was there, this was nothing else have this to do a meal, this motivation, and she was a strong fighter, and I need her really for my good results, and every time when she was in a competition, there was, you can feel it in the air, like like 91 when Carl Lewis with Mike Powell in a competition,
That's right.
Was so, it's always nice, and she's a nice person, and but strong fighter.
Yes. Berlin 2009, those world championships, I haven't been to all of them, but I've been to most of them. It's my favorite. I see a lot of other people saying Berlin 2009 is my favorite world championships. I want to know where you spent the world championships. Were you in the stadium every day? And what was your role during those world championships? Or did you just get to come and enjoy it as a fan?
I have good members in this stadium, the Olympic Stadium.
Of course.
I jumped there, and of course I'm visit the competition, the last meetings, and it's always great. And it's a big atmosphere. And I remember 2009. This was nice. It was nice atmosphere, and the people was very close to the athletes. And this lane is very fast, and the people enjoyed it to compete there. And hopefully for future, it's something in my mind. Maybe Olympic Games, we try.
and don't forget, you guys still have the 100 meter and 200 meter world record on that surface, right?
Yeah,
9.5 and 19. I want to ask you now about your longevity. You started as a prodigy. You were very good, very, very young. And yet your last successes came well into your 30s. How were you able to keep your body going for that long? Because most people in this sport who are prodigies, they don't make it all the way. And you not only made it all the way, but then you kept going to a good age.
Must be a little also lucky for my body.
Yeah.
Of course.
And you had injuries. I remember some of your
injuries.
It
comes later.
Yes.
When
yes.
I'm getting older.
Yes.
And it comes to injuries. But I was over 30 then it comes to first injuries. Before I can, for me, was I have good coaches,
yes,
and they take care of me. And I think I can. I have a good training every year, so and then let's make the results then a success results. Zeffin 48. It was little injuries, and by the way, but not big injuries, so that I can train very well and I have good coaches. I think it's important to have a good team with you, to be on so long time. But the passion was there always, so I enjoy, I love my sports, and of course I love success too, and everybody. And I think it's training, it's technique, it's so many things to make you in good shape for so long time.
When you look back at your own career, could you give me one highlight? Is there one thing, one event, one night, one medal that stands above everything else? And if so, why does it stand out for you?
It's difficult.
You have a lot of medals.
I think it was the first one.
The first one?
It was 83, was Helsinki. Mm-hmm. Because I was very young, I was just 18 years, and I come in this national team from the GDR, and it always was strong, and I was really shy, and there was a big athlete from Romania, big long jumper, Anisua Kuzmia is the name, and she jumped before world record in the long jump, 7:40 something like this, and I was 7:40. Can't believe that. And I know we have a nice fight in the competition, and I win. Right. Yes.
Was nice. No surprise, your favorite memory is a win.
But it was important. I think that you don't be afraid for big names or for big results, but when you are then in the competition, then everybody is the same. So and this is just the head and the fight in the competition, and I think this competition was important for the years after these games. And the last one, of course, the 2000.
Yeah.
This was crazy Olympic Games, because I was 35 years old, and it was a difficult year in Sydney before the training was injured, and you train, and maybe you know it, you train and then you come injured and you get sad and you have to step back and then come again, and then in this competition everything works. And then you stand there and you're again Olympic champion. This is so
again
crazy.
What when you look back, I mean, I certainly don't miss the training, but I miss the camaraderie with my teammates. What do you miss most about your career that's not related to the track, maybe?
Yeah, that's the training camps.
No, and, nobody loves. We all hate the training.
No, we plan something make a training camp with old friends.
Of course.
The friends, of course. You are standing so long time. I have the same memories. You train together, you eat together, you compete together, and there is something with some relationships. It's more relationships, and but it's nice that you can have a good contact to all of them, and what they're. In good shape, and we meet each other.
I grew up watching you compete. I think you are one of the greatest athletics competitors of all time, and I am very happy anytime I see retired athletes as happy as you are post-retirement. So thank you for joining me.
Thanks,
and all the best to you.
Too. Merci.